Now see this, guys. ABC company had cash collections of $50,000 and made cash payments of $20,000. So if you see that what they have done, ABC company had cash collections of $50,000. Guys, everyone, I want you to focus this with utmost importance. This is one example which is really very, very important in the CPA exam, and just the entire accounting, the entire journal entries, the entire concept of accounting is there in this example number one, which is converting from cash basis to accrual basis. One who have understood this example can master any journal entry. I repeat this again. One who have understood this example can master any journal entry. For him, no journal entry can be tough. Okay. So let us focus on that. So ABC company had cash collections of $50,000. Made cash payment of $20,000 and reported a cash basis net income of $30,000. So if you see that their net income, how much they have reported, guys? $30,000. The company has determined the following balance sheet amounts for the beginning and ending of year six. So account receivable, closing balance is given, opening balance is given. Prepaid insurance, closing balance is given, opening balance is given. Unearned service revenue, opening balance is 20,000. See, they have reversed it. Normally, we have a habit of seeing first opening, second closing. But in this question, see the way they have written the question itself. That itself is very confusing. Are you able to see that, guys? The beginning balances are on the right-hand side. The closing balances are on the left-hand side. This itself can make a lot of students do mistake. Because the examiner very well know that you sleep when you are trying to solve the problem. So these dreaming kind of students will find this example as very, very tough. Okay. So be really alert when you're reading the question of this sort of things. So if you see that opening balances are on right hand side, closing balances are on left hand side. Okay. So unearned service revenue is 20,000 and closing is at 5,000. Salaries payable 3,000, opening and closing is $7,000. So ABC company have purchased a piece of equipment on 1st January year 6 for $5,000 in cash. The equipment has no salvage value and will be depreciated on a straight line basis over the 5 years. Now tell me, guys, don't see the solution at all, because in Becker book, they have made it really difficult, the solution. So let us see if we can solve this properly. So what we will do here is we'll open the T accounts and try to see what is it and all. Okay. So now the first account, what we'll open, first of all, the ledgers. So we will solve this entire chapter through T accounts. I think if some of them who have attended the basics class, right? So we will open the ledger for this. So we have the accounts receivable ledger. So you open ledgers only for the payable and receivable balances, which are the balance sheet items. You have the ledgers for that, expenditure and incomes and all. You normally have P&Ls. So here we'll have debit. So here we'll have debit and here we'll have credit. So that's the account receivable. Now tell me, guys, what all comes under account receivable? What do you think? What all should come under accounts receivable? In a ledger of account receivable, what all would you notice? Credit sale. Yes, other than credit sale. So what is the journal entry for credit? So one is telling opening balance. Yes. So opening balance. Then you have closing balance. So let us write closing balance at the end. Okay. Then what do we have actually? Opening balance, closing balance is done. Some of them are telling. So I've kept an internal inner column and outer column. And here also the closing balance is there. Next, credit sale. So what is the journal entry for credit sale, guys? Should I put on the debit side or credit side of the account receivable, everyone? Where should I put? Should I put buy or should I put two? So it is two sales. Yes. So two credit sales. Okay. Next, it is not buy, it is two. Accounts receivable is debited, sales is credited. So in the account receivable ledger, it will come on debit side because you have debited accounts receivable, right? In the T format, that's why I've written two here. Else I would have written buy. Next, cash collection. Only Mehul will answer this. Please stop it there. Yes, Mehul, cash collection. On account receivable side, will you put a debit side or credit side? Cash collection, you will not record at all. From the receivables, if you receive the cash, you will not record the journal entry itself, is it? What's the journal entry then for cash collection from receivables? Yes, what's the journal entry for cash collection from receivable? Cash to debtors. So Mehul, why are you telling that it will not be recorded in account receivable? What is account receivable? Is it not a debtor in Indian terminology? Is account receivable is not a debtor? Good. So it will come by cash. Okay. So here one more important thing. Can you see the question now? What is the opening balance of account receivable, everyone? Notice it carefully. It is on the right hand side. Opening balance of account receivable is $10,000. Okay. Closing balance of account receivable is how much? Yes, everyone. Closing balance of account receivable is $15,000. Do we have any cash collected from debtors? Yes, guys. Do we have 50,000? Did they give in the question or not? They are receiving 50,000 cash collected from the debtors there. In the first question itself, first line, ABC company had cash collections of $50,000. So can I write here, guys, cash account debit, account receivable credit, your receivable will reduce to the extent of what you have received the cash. Am I right on that, everyone? Your receivable should reduce to the extent of the cash collected. Do you agree with this? Can we plot there 50,000? Okay, perfect. So buy cash 50,000. So now what are we doing there? We have something called as unearned revenue. So unearned revenue, if you see that, the last year unearned revenue will reduce my debtors this year, yes or no? And the current year unearned revenue will go in as a accrued sales. Do you agree with this, everyone? See there, just wait for there. Ye sabke liye naya hai, unearned revenue. Everyone knows still accounts receivable, right? But what about unearned revenue? So if you see that last year unearned revenue will become this year as a receivable collections or not? So it will reduce to that extent. I am just reversing the journal entry what I have passed earlier. So because last year we have received this year, so we are putting it as buy unearned, and this year we are recording as a current unearned revenue. What is the current unearned revenue? Account receivable to unearned revenue. Sir, when can we get this journal entry? Account receivable debited with credit to unearned revenue when you invoice the goods. Normally we think unearned revenue is only when you receive the cash in advance. Do you agree with this? Normally unearned revenue, we always think that it is always in cash in advance. But can it happen like that? I might have invoiced also and I might have recognized a receivable, but cash he will give it after 2-3 months, and then services he will record after 4-5 months. Can it happen or not, everyone? I can invoice it in January. I will pay cash in March. I will deliver the services in June. Can it happen like that or not? Jan, April, June. So you can have an entry with account receivable debit, credit to unearned revenue. Sir, why did you record? We are following an accrual concept or not? The moment you invoice it, I should particularly accrue that particular thing or not? I'm liable to that extent. My liability has straight away started the moment I have actually invoiced it. Is it clear, everyone? That is the time that journal entry will come, account receivable debit, credit unearned revenue. Sometimes you might receive in advance. So that time, what would be the journal entry? Sometimes you might receive cash in advance. That time, what would be the journal entry, everyone? Cash account debit, credit unearned, yes or no? Now I'm not receiving the cash. I've just invoiced the goods. So the journal entry will be account receivable debit, credit unearned or not? Because I can't put revenue. Why can't I put revenue? Yes, guys, debit account receivable, credit revenue. Why can't I put revenue? Why can't I put revenue? Because we didn't provide the services. Perfect. Superb. Awesome, guys. So now what is the balancing figure here in the ledger? This should be the balancing figure or not, guys? Everyone, guys, do you agree with this? This should be the balancing figure because this is the one which is left over. So 50 plus 20. Yes, 70 plus 85 minus 15. What is the credit sales? That is my accrued revenue. Guys, if you want to follow the Becker method also, I have absolutely no problem. It is up to you. So I really don't understand the Becker method. Okay. So it's like memorizing the things. So excuse me for that, because I will not be teaching from that pluses and minuses, because what happens in that pluses and minuses, you might go wrong. Right. So that is the reason why I'm not taking. Wherever that is applicable, we will use that method. Wherever it is not applicable, we will use our T account format. So is this clear to everyone? If you see that 70,000 is the balancing figure of the credit sale. So credit sales is nothing but your accrued revenue or not. Now see there, for expenses, it's not easy to do a ledger account, because we'll need to do a simple calculation there, because this is an expenditure. So cash paid is how much, guys? So now I want to calculate accrued basis expenditure. Okay, this is a cash paid. We thought that this is our expenditure. Is this your expenditure, everyone? 20,000 under cash basis method. Is this your expenditure or not? 20,000. Okay. Now what have happened actually in this 20,000? So if you see that they have debited, they have purchased a piece of equipment for $5,000 in cash. They have included that $5,000 in this particular thing. Is that an expenditure? They have actually included in 20,000, 5,000 fixed asset also. Normally, what is a journal entry? Journal entry for assets, fixed assets, debit, cash is credited. Yes, so you have included that. So should I exclude that or not, everyone? Is that my expenditure? It's not my expenditure. It's a fixed asset. Fixed asset is not an expenditure under accrual basis. So normally the purchaser's account debit or fixed asset account debit, credit is cash. So that will go and sit under balance sheet. It doesn't affect the P&L account. So our objective is what, guys? What are we trying to achieve? Are we trying to achieve accrued basis revenue or not accrued basis expenditure? Yes. So what should I do now? So depreciation, should I add back to depreciation? Net 4,000 should be subtracted, because we have a 1 year depreciation. If you see that you have purchased an equipment for 5,000 and for 5 years under straight line method basis, every year depreciation should be $1,000. Do you agree with this, everyone? $5,000 divided by 5 years, every year $1,000. Agree or not, everyone? So 5,000 of 1,000. So $1,000 depreciation you should record, and $5,000 you shouldn't have recorded. So net, can I put 4,000? Yes, can I reduce net 4,000? So what I can do here is less capitalized one, which is how much, guys? 5,000. And add back depreciation, because that have not been charged. So I have added back. But depreciation is a non-cash expenditure. So that's why we have added back no ready, because we are following accrual basis. And accrual basis, will you record non-cash expenditure or not? Next question, if you see that there, what is the next adjustments we have, guys? We have salaries. See there, if we followed an cash basis method, would we have recorded liability? Yes, everyone. If we are following cash basis method, do we record a liability? We don't record a liability. So should you record the liability or not to that extent actually? Yes, so should you add back whatever adjustments are there? See there, salaries payable last year was 3,000. Current year it is 7,000. So should I add back salaries payable also here to that extent? Yes, everyone. Expenditure account debit to expenses payable account. What is a journal entry for payables? Do we debit expenses and credit the payable or not, everyone? Yes. So last year, how much was the salary? 3,000 on year one was salaries, and year two, and how much it have become, guys? 7,000. So there is an increase in salary. So what is that increase actually? Is that a current year expenditure or not? Yes, everyone, I'll go against law. It was year one, 3,000. Current year, it is an expenditure or not? Is it a current year expenditure? So should I add back to this or not? He might not have included at all that current year expenditure of salaries. See there, year one was 3,000, year two, 7,000. So there is an increase of $4,000. So that's my current year expenditure. He have not given any effect to that $20,000. That $20,000 doesn't include these particular adjustments. Because why will it not include? Because they have not even considered. Liabilities are anyways not shown in the cash balance sheet. Are you getting it, guys? So that is very much assumed. Now, very, very good question. Harpreet is asking, sir, why are we adding? If we will pay, then cash will go down. So please understand, Harpreet. This is a, do you first understand that current year accrual, did you would have given effect had you followed cash basis method? This is how you need to think. If you would have followed a cash balance method, would you have given effect to outstanding salaries? That is my question. would you have given effect to outstanding salaries? What is outstanding salaries? They are the salaries accrued but not paid in cash. In this 3,000 to 7,000 increase, is it not so, Harpreet, there is a $4,000 increase in salaries? Do you agree with this? From 3,000 to 7,000, there is a $4,000 increase in salaries. That is definitely not in cash. Is it in cash? Yes, Harpreet, is it in cash? It is not in cash. So $3,000 to $7,000, what is that $4,000 increase? That is salaries account debit to salaries payable. Is it not a payable entry? Is it not a payable entry? So that is the reason we are adding it, because we haven't given that payable entry effect to the cash balance method. Okay. Next comes the insurance. Now, if you see that insurance, year one, what is the insurance, guys? Can someone help me with prepaid insurance figures? Year one, what is the insurance, everyone? Year one is 2000. Year two is how much, guys? Insurance. This is reverse of your expenditure. This is a prepaid. So you have paid it in advance or not, guys? So there is a $2,000 prepaid. Yes or no? Year one, it was 2000. And year two, it is 4000. So in current year, you have paid 2000 extra. So is that your cash expenditure, everyone? $2,000 prepaid. Does prepaid affect your cash balance? Is it an expenditure? See, I agree $2,000 is a cash expenditure, but is it an expenditure under accrual? Prepaid expenditure debit to cash account. Is it an accrual basis expenditure? It is not an accrual basis. So what should I do? I will exclude this. Are you getting it? Less prepaid expenditure. So how much is that? $2,000. That's all is the answer. So now what is the accrual basis net income, guys? Now they are asking accrual basis net income, 70,000 minus your revenue minus your expenditure. Perfect, guys. Next, question number one. Let us see question number one, guys. Ward, a consultant. So Ward, a consultant, keeps our accounting records on cash basis during year two. Ward collected $2 lakh in fees from clients. Yes, guys. So that is a cash collection or not, everyone? See there, Ward, a consultant, keeps our accounting records on cash basis. During year two, Ward collected $2 lakh in fees from the client. So is that a cash collection? It will come under debit side or credit side of our T account. It will come under the credit side. On December 31st, what is the opening balance? $40,000. What is the closing balance? $60,000. Unearned fees, how much closing? Is $5,000. So what do? We will plot all this in our Excel sheet. So let us see in the T account. Again, we will follow the T account. Yes, guys, what is the opening balance? $40,000. What is the closing balance? $60,000. What is the cash collected from debtors? $2 lakh. We don't have any opening unearned. We have the closing unearned. How much it is? $5,000. So what is the balancing figure? So this will be your balancing figure. So 2,60,000 minus 45,000, it comes $2,15,000. Okay. So $2,15,000, option C should be the correct answer. So that is the credit sales. Is it fine, guys? I hope you are able to understand what am I doing here. Okay. Next question. Question number two. Savarco had $1 lakh in accrual basis pre-tax income. Okay. Savarco had $1 lakh in accrual basis pre-tax income. What are we following, guys, here? Accrual basis or cash basis? This is accrual to cash. Last question, may we did cash to accrual or not, guys? Now this is accrual to cash. Okay. So Savarco had $1 lakh in accrual basis pre-tax income for the year. At year end, account receivable had increased by $10,000. So what should I do, guys? This is accrual to cash. My account receivable had increased by $10,000. That means there is a revenue. There is an accrued basis revenue or not? Yes, guys. What do you think? 1 lakh. So 1 lakh, there is a $10,000 increase in account receivable in cash. Had I followed a cash basis method, would I have recorded the increase in receivable, everyone? Had I followed cash basis method, should I have recorded the increase in receivable? Had we recorded? No, that's a credit basis, not no effect. Not no effect, because this is already given an alert. This 1 lakh actually includes this $10,000 also, because this is an accrual basis revenue. Everyone, are you able to understand that? So what are we trying to do is 1 lakh minus 10,000. So 90,000 is one. Okay, so that is done. So should you reduce that account receivable, everyone? This was already included, because increase in receivable is nothing but your credit sales. In cash basis method, we don't record credit sales. So I have reduced it. Why did you reduce, sir? Because it was already included in it. Is it clear, everyone? Okay, next one. Accounts payable had decreased by $6,000. So now accounts payable had decreased by $6,000. That means what? I have paid the account payable. So what is a journal entry when the account payable had reduced? Account payable is debited. Cash is credited, guys. Cash is not received. When accounts payable reduces, do you receive cash or do you pay cash? When accounts payable get reduced, do you receive cash or do you pay cash? What is accounts payable? It's a liability. It's not a receivable. It's a liability. If liability reduces, you pay cash or not? To that extent, there are creditors. So if I pay creditors, so $6,000 will be a reduction or not in cash basis method? That's an expenditure or not, everyone? Guys, in cash basis method, that's an expenditure or not? So should I reduce that or not? So 10,000 plus 6,000, 16,000 minus 1 lakh. What is the correct answer? Yes, guys, what's the correct answer? $84,000. Option A is the correct answer. Is it clear, everyone? Now let us see if you would have got this question right or not. Now I want everyone tell me this. Cash basis income is $60,000. Let us see one additional example. I just want to be comfortable and satisfied that you have understood the logic. Okay. So just for my satisfaction, I have given this question. So cash basis income, guys, is $60,000. Okay. Account receivable in year one, opening account receivable is 20,000. Closing account receivable is 40,000. My objective is to arrive at accrual basis income. What should I do, guys, now? So 60,000. Now account receivable. There is an increase in account receivable here. So should I add back or should I subtract? So cash basis income is 60,000. So account receivable is 20,000. Closing account receivable is 40,000. There is an increase in account receivable to certain extent. So $15,000. Should I add back $20,000? Should I add back or not? Yes. Is there an addition? Okay. Next. Accounts payable 30,000 opening and closing at the end 15,000. So there is a decrease in accounts payable. So what should we do, guys? Should I add back or should I subtract? It should be added back. Please understand, in cash basis method, he have debited this $15,000. But is that reduction in accounts payable? Is it an expenditure kya under accrual basis? Reduction in liability. What is a journal entry for liability reduction? Accounts payable debited and cash is credited. Is it an expenditure? Yeah, under accrual basis. Everyone, payable to cash. So what should I do? I should add back this or not? Yes, guys. Should I add back that or not? It's not an expenditure. So see there, guys. 30,000. So first step, is it clear to everyone? $20,000. Why are we adding back, sir? That is an increase in receivable or not? Credit sales. In cash basis method, we have not recorded credit sales, everyone. Do you agree with this? These 20,000 we have not recorded in cash basis. So should I add back that? Increase in receivable, should I add back? Why did you guys get confused in increase in accounts payable? You thought they have already paid. So that will be a reduction. But no, that expenditure is not a reduction. Are you getting what we are trying to explain you? Are you able to understand how difficult it is? It's not easy what it looks like. You need to be very, very careful, guys. You want me to repeat accounts payable again, everyone? Okay, so see there, accounts payable in year one was 30,000. In year two, at the end, the accounts payable is 15,000. Matlab current year mein, you have paid 15,000 or not? See, boss, last year you had 30 rupees. To your creditors, you had to give 30 rupees. At year end, to your creditor, you have only 15 rupees. That means in current year, you have paid to creditors 15 rupees or not? Yes or no? So that means we have paid. But is that an expenditure under accrual? Because we follow cash basis method.
So that is an expenditure under cash. I completely agree. There is absolutely no denying. But under accrual, reduction in liability is an expenditure. It is not an expenditure, no. So that is the reason why I have added back, because I debited it mistakenly under cash basis. Since I followed cash basis, so I reduced it. Now under accrual basis, I need to add back that or not, because this cash basis income already includes the effect of accounts payable. Is it clear, everyone? Let me see how much you have understood it. Let me give you one more example. Yes, guys. So if you see that MK Enterprises Bank has requested that MK provide it with a GAAP financial statement in order to obtain a line of credit. MK has asked you to prepare the journal entries needed to adjust its financial statement from cash basis to accrual basis. See the effect, guys? He is asking from cash to accrual, not accrual to cash. Till here, is it clear to everyone? What is the question's objective? It is from cash to accrual. The journal entry number corresponds to information number. All information is located in the exhibit. For the situations below, record the appropriate journal entries. Right? So there are how many journals we need to do in this question? 8 journal entries. Let us see the first journal entry. See the exhibits. Okay, so what have happened in this particular thing? MK Enterprises Inc. started business on January 1st, year 1. We will go slow and steady. There is absolutely no hurry. Okay, MK Enterprises Inc. started business on January 1st, year 1 and keeps its books on the cash basis accounting. Guys, what basis of accounting is following, everyone? Yes, everyone, cash basis accounting. The trial balance of the company, they have given cash. Credit, common stock, sales, you have given $40,000. Cost of sales is $20,000. $8,000 payroll expenditure. Selling expense is $3,000. Administrative expenses, $5,000. Small tools expenditure. Guys, what do you think? Without seeing the next point, can someone tell me, guys, this is just a guess, okay? I'm not expecting you to answer, just a guess. Very good, Prajakta. Very, very good. Very good. See, this fellow have recorded small tools as an expenditure. That's a fixed asset. Yes or no, everyone? Excellent. Very good presence of mind. So we will give effect. Right now, I'm just telling you. See, when you are reading the question only, you must calculate in your mind what is going on. Okay. So sales 40,000 minus 20,000 cost of sales. 8,000, 20 plus 8, 28,000 plus 3, 31,000 plus 5, 36,000 plus 5, 41,000. So 40 minus 41,000 is the net income or not? Negative, everyone, under cash basis. Are they reporting loss or not under cash basis method, everyone? 40,000 minus 20,000 minus it. Is this all expenditures or not? Cost of sales, payroll expenses, selling expense, admin, small tools, because this is cash basis method. I haven't even started accrual. Is it clear, everyone? Till here, is it clear to everyone? $1,000 negative. Income tax expenses is $4,000. We will see later what have happened in income tax. Okay. Other information about MK's operations. So customer owes a company $20,000 on unpaid invoices at the end of the year. What should I do, guys, here? Yes, everyone. What's the journal entry? First journal entry, customer owes the company $20,000 on unpaid invoices at the end of the year. What's the journal entry we will put straight away? Yes, everyone, account receivable to sales. Yes, everyone, account receivable to sales. Yes or no? So first journal entry, can I put accounts receivable debit? How much is the amount, guys? $20,000. Can I put like that, everyone? And what is the next account? Sales. So these fellow have not recorded that $20,000 sale. So 40,000 plus 20,000. Now my current sales is 60,000 or not. This is how you need to remember. You need to be real smart when you're solving these questions. Right now my sales have increased from 40 to 60 or not, everyone. This fellow have not recorded. But you should record or not. Okay. Till here, is it clear? Okay. See there, next point. The company has a goods with cost of $12,000 in its warehouse at the year end. So did they record that or not? Did they record, guys? They didn't record. See there, company has still goods with $12,000 in inventory. So what is a journal entry we will pass? They still purchase a cost of goods with $12,000 in its warehouse at year end. The company owes its supplier for all of these goods. Plus they owe another $2,000 on a prior shipment that was sold during the year. First was sold, second is not sold. So what is the first journal entry? $12,000. What is a journal entry, everyone? Yes, what's the journal entry for $12,000? What do you think? Inventory account debited to accounts payable? Yes or no? Sir, in India, we do purchases account to party account or not? Yes, everyone. Did we used to do in India purchases to party account or not? Normally, I'm talking from Indian context. But in US GAAP, they record cost entry and sale entry separately or not? Didn't I explain that in revenue recognition? Everyone, inventory. Yes, inventory to accounts payable, cost of goods sold. Again, the entry to inventory. So that's what we used to do in the revenue chapter. So here, the company has a goods with a cost of $12,000 in its warehouse at its year end. So what is a journal entry I should pass? We'll not debit purchases. We'll debit what? Actually, this is a cost entry. So we'll debit inventory and we'll debit accounts payable, not cost of goods sold. Why, Pragnesh? Why not cost of goods sold? Are they consumed, Pragnesh? Is this consumed, Pragnesh, $12,000? It is not consumed, right? So can I credit cost of goods sold? Can I credit? No, I can't credit. And never you will credit cost of goods sold. It is always debited. Are you getting it? Are you getting it, Pragnesh? You will never have cost of goods sold credit side. It is an expenditure. It's always debited. So when inventory gets consumed, the entry will be COGS to inventory. Are you getting it, everyone? Yes, Priyanka, that's right. You have got that entry correct, everyone. So inventory account debited with accounts payable. I will debit inventory because it's still in warehouse. So what is the amount, guys? $12,000 and accounts payable is how much? $12,000. So it should come under second row. Actually, I've kept in the first row in mistakenly. I apologize for that. So inventory is debited with what, guys? $12,000 and accounts payable is credited with $12,000. Here you will get that particular entry. So now next, inventory to accounts payable. Next, what is the information we have? Okay, what's the second information? Now, plus they owe another $2,000 on a prior shipment that was sold during the year, guys. Now, what is the journal entry you will have? See there, guys, they owe another $2,000 on a prior shipment. Are you getting it? So what's the journal entry for $2,000 now? Yes, everyone. What's the journal entry? What's the journal entry for $2,000? Yes, everyone. Accounts payable to cost of goods sold. Wrong, wrong. Inventory to accounts payable. Wrong. Because inventory is already done last year. So you will not give effect to inventory at all. There is no effect on inventory at all. Okay. Inventory is already done. Cost of goods sold is also not done. So here you have cost of sales. So you can use the word cost of sales here. So you will debit cost of sales. So there's nothing called a cost of goods sold here in this choice. So that's why we are selecting cost of goods sold. Cost of goods sold or cost of sales. So one and the same. So cost of sales debited with $2,000. And then you have credit again with accounts payable because he didn't pay till now. Are you getting it? He's still owing $2,000. He's still owing $2,000. He didn't give $12,000 also. He didn't give $2,000 also. Like in India, we don't pay money to our friends. This fellow is also not paying to that supplier nicely. So that's an effect. Are you getting it? Inventory debited, cost of sales debited with $2,000. Now see the effect. Now guys, step by step, this $2,000, should you give, should you add or should you subtract to your cash basis method, everyone? Should you add or should you subtract this $2,000? Guys, this $2,000, should you add or should you subtract? Again, I'm telling, this $2,000, should you add or should you subtract? Again, I am asking, $2,000, should you add or should you subtract? Should you add or should you subtract? This is an income. See there, guys. In cash income, we have not considered that expenditure. Is that an expenditure or not under accrual? Everyone, is that an expenditure or not under accrual? So should you add or should you subtract then? Why are you telling add then? You should reduce or not? That's why I am telling you need to be very, very careful. Cash to accrual method. Your starting point is cash, guys. Under cash basis method, did he record that $2,000? He will not record. He will not record because he didn't pay only. In cash basis method, only when we pay, we record that as an expenditure. Do you agree, everyone? I'm taking a pause here to explain you. In cash basis method, till you don't pay, you don't record that as an expenditure. Yes or no? So that is that fellow, did he record that as an expenditure? He didn't record. So what should you do? Under accrual basis, we should record that or not? Even though I have not paid, it is still my liability or not? We follow accrual basis method. So should we record that or not? Yes. Are you getting it? I hope you are able to understand what am I telling. Okay. Next. See there, the amount the company shows as small tools is for the principal manufacturing asset for the company. The company depreciates its fixed assets on a straight line basis with a 5-year asset life. See there, guys, what that fellow have done? Yes, guys, this $5,000 he have debited as expenditure. See there, the amount the company shows as small tools is for the principal manufacturing asset of the company. The company depreciates his fixed assets on a straight line basis, but he have already debited it. So what should I do now? What is the journal entry we will pass? First of all, fixed assets to expenses. Good, good. Keep it up. And depreciation to accumulated depreciation. So you will add back 5,000. You will subtract 1,000. So quickly, guys. So journal entry 3, factory expenses. There is factory equipment is debited. And what will be credited, guys? Small tools. Where is small tools? I'm not finding small tools. Okay. How much is the amount, guys? Yes, quickly, guys. $5,000. I am giving effect. And small tools, I will reverse out. And small tools is out from the system. Depreciation will be debited with $1,000 because it's a 5-year depreciation. Every year, $1,000. And accumulated depreciation will be credited with $1,000. Agree, guys? Yes, can I put like that? Okay, perfect. Now let us see next one, journal entry 4. So 1, 2, 3 done, 2, 3 done, fourth one. Included in administrative expenses is a payment on the company's 1-year general liability insurance policy for $2,400. Guys, see this, the policy was purchased on July 1st year 1. This fellow have actually debited entire $2,400. But see there, when did he purchase, guys? On July 1st, year 1 or not? So what should we do actually? To that extent, there is a prepaid insurance or not? Yes, everyone. To that extent, is there a prepaid insurance or not? So what will you debit? Prepaid insurance debit and insurance expenditure credit or not? So he'll reverse out insurance to certain extent of 1200. He debited entire 2400. How much he should have debited, guys? Guys, actually, how much he should have debited? To 1200 only. How much did he debit? 1200 or not? How much did he debit? 2400. Actually, how much he should have debited? 1200 only or not? So we are following cash basis method. So should I add back or should I subtract? 1200. Should I add back or should I subtract? Yes, 1200 we will add back. Good. Now you are getting it very nicely. Entry will be prepaid insurance. Where is prepaid insurance? Prepaid. Guys, now are you confident a bit? I know you will require practice. I'm not denying that. But still 40% confidence you have got on this concept. Everyone, are you able to understand what are we talking here? So prepaid insurance debit and credit will be what? Administrative expenses, because he have given administrative expenses 2400, which is incorrect. It should have been only 1200, because other 1200 is prepaid for next year, because 6 months policy, July year purchase. So next 6 months it is prepaid. Okay. Now fifth one, question number 5, when reconciling the bank accounts for the year, guys, this fellow, the company discovered that it had received a $500 bad check from a customer. See there, the check was redeposited and paid in January of year 2. So what should we do now? See there, guys, when reconciling the bank account, the customer discovered that it had received a $500 bad check from a customer. The check was redeposited and paid in the January of year 2. Are you getting it? So what should we do in this journal entry? I am asking only the journal entry. Account receivable debit and credit will be bank account. That's the right entry. See there, guys. Account receivable debit and cash will be credited because see there, it is still not debited. Are you getting it? So you should reclassify that into the account receivable. Are you able to understand what are we trying to do there? So account receivable debit and credit will be bank account with $500. Account receivable debit credit would be, so cash and bank is not there, so it's just a $500. So I'm taking cash. So account receivable debit credit would be $500. Yes, Roma. So see there, guys. So in journal entry 5, what have they done actually? Yes, so they haven't deposited it. So I'm just reversing out what they have included as their thing. So see there, when reconciling the bank account, the company discovered that it had received a $500 bad check from a customer. So it should debit the account receivable and credit the cash. Sir, why did we credit the cash? Yes, everyone. Why did we credit cash? See there, when did he paid actually? Bank was debited earlier. But actually see there, the check was redeposited and paid in January of year 2. Are you getting it? So that is why we have again reduced our AR to that extent. Are you able to understand, everyone? So that's where we have credited the cash and we have debited the accounts receivable in this question. When we deposit, we would have reduced the AR. But did we deposit here? We didn't deposit only. We deposited next year. So that's why we are again inflating our AR to certain extent, to that extent of $500. Okay. Now, next journal entry, guys. The company estimates that 1.5% of its sales will eventually be uncollectible. See there, guys. Did we record this 1.5% of sales in cash method? Did we record that under cash method? We would not have recorded because this is an estimation. This is a provision. What is your writing? It's a provision. We would have never recorded. Guys, again, I'm telling, in cash basis method, you record only when the event happen, not when event will happen. Is it clear, everyone? When event will happen, that time only you will record, not when event to be happened. Here event happened or it will happen. Yes, in question number 6, will event will happen or will it be happen or it have already happened? Is it happened or it will happen? Yes, everyone. See there, it estimates. What do you mean by estimation? That they are estimating that it will happen. So this might have not recorded at all under the cash basis method. Is it clear? So 40,000 was your sale. So 40,000 into 1.5%. Is it right? Yes, everyone. What was your sales? 40,000 into 1.5%. Is it right, everyone? Yes, guys. 40,000 into 1.5% or 60,000 into 1.5%. What should I do, everyone? What is my revenue? Yes, in the first point only I clarified. What was our revenue actually? 40,000 plus 20,000, 60,000 into 1.5%. So $900 is my bad debt expenditure. Yes or no? So what's the journal entry? So journal entry 6, bad debt expense debit and credit would be what, guys? Yes, everyone. Bad debt expense debit with 900. Credit would be what? Just now I said, is it happen or will it happen? How can you reduce your account receivable? You will root through your provision. That provision will go under balance sheet and that will reduce your account receivable. This is not a direct write-off method. This is a provision. This is an estimation, everyone. You cannot directly credit account receivable. You cannot reduce straight away. You will root through provision, allowance for uncollectible account, everyone. You cannot directly reduce your bad debts. I mean account receivable. Yes, account receivable, because that is an estimation. So we are passing through provision. Okay. Now journal entry 7. Let us see. So this $900, guys, under cash basis method, should we add or should we subtract? Yes, everyone. Should we add or should we subtract? We should subtract. Okay. Provision for bad debts or uncollectible allowance for uncollectible are one and the same. In India, we call provision for bad debts. here in US they call allowance for uncollectible. Okay, so under cash basis they didn't record at all. So now we will subtract. Good, Kanchana. The company pays its employees on a weekly basis 7 days after the end of pay period, guys. So they will pay after 7 days. The last payback check for the year was December 31st. The weekly payroll for the company is $1,300. What is the journal entry? Yes, everyone. He will pay after 7 days. So what? Under accrual basis, should you record that or not? Salary to salary payable? Yes, everyone. Yes or no? So how much is the amount? $1,300. So payroll expenditure debit and accrued salaries credit. So see there, payroll expenditure. Where is the payroll expenses? There is no salary, Valerie. In US, they call payroll. Use some posh thing. Now you're doing CPA. Don't use words of salary and all. In interview also, you can tell payroll. See, it looks very posh, okay? So you're doing payroll and all like that. So don't use salary and all kind of stuff, okay? So payroll expenditure debit. And next is accrued payroll. How much is that? $1,300. Yes, guys, under cash basis method, what do we do now? Will you reduce that $1,300 or not, everyone? Okay. So next is what actually? The last journal entry will be your taxation entry. Now see that. Now what is company's tax rate is 25%. So now we will prepare the RECO here. Okay, so RECO, now I'm going back to the Excel sheet. Everyone, okay. Did you note down all those things or didn't you note down? Everyone, did you note down all those items or none of them have note down? Very good. So I'll have to go back to the solution itself because then you'll not able to relate in the sim. So if you see that our explanation, so 20,000, 12,000, 5,000, all those effects. So I'm going into the solution directly. So see there, guys, cash basis pre-tax income. Everyone, are you able to see the screen or pecker? $1,000 negative sales we have added back. Because that's our accrued sales. We have reduced cost of sales 2000. We have added back 5000. We have subtracted $1,000. We have added back $1,200 because it's our administrative expenditure. We have reduced bad debt expenditure because that was not recorded. Payroll expenditure was not recorded, $1,300. So now the entire income from negative $1,000 in cash basis have become to positive $20,000 in accrual basis. What is the moral of the story? Always follow accrual basis method. So 20,000 into 25% is $5,000. But what was estimation, guys? $4,000 or not? In the question, they said estimation or not. Estimation tax was $4,000, everyone. Do you remember the question that time? So $5,000 is now the fresh. So what is the journal entry of 8? Journal entry 8. What is the journal entry for 8? 8th journal entry, what will you pass? Income tax expenditure with additional $1,000 or not? Should you accrue additional liability of $1,000, everyone? From 4,000 estimation, now it is how much? 5,000. So income tax expenditure to income tax expenditure payable. That is the last journal entry. Income tax expenditure 1,000. Income tax payable $1,000. That's all we had from module 7. I hope you are able to understand this. So guys, some quickly we'll do some T accounts just to ensure that you never forget this also. Yes, in accounts payable now, tell me guys, what all comes under debit side and what all comes under the credit side? We have done that in revenue, the ledgers, trying to explain that with the T accounts. First comes accounts payable because I've seen in the Becker book. They are given add accounts payable, subtract accounts payable and all sort of stuff. So we will understand that also through our T account. So accounts payable, guys, on the credit side, what will it come? Yes, everyone, accounts payable ledger I've opened. What will come under accounts payable ledger? Accounts payable ledger. I've opened the ledger first of all. So you should give opening balance, closing balance. Yes. So by opening balance or by closing balance, what is it actually? Yes, everyone. Is it by or is it to? Is it by balance brought down? Yes or no? So by balance brought down on the credit side. Then you have two balance brought down. Debit side, two balance brought down. Next, what all comes under the, yes, discount and all is fine. Next, yes, cash payment. Yes, what is the journal entry? Debit and credit side don't. So first is the cash payment. What is the journal entry we'll have? First is the payment to creditors. Yes or no? So accounts payable debited.
credited will be cash. Yes, guys, accounts payable to cash, AP to cash. So here should I write to cash purchases or to cash paid? Yes, what is the balancing figure now? Yes, everyone, what is the balancing figure? Opening, closing accounts payable and cash payment. Yes, so buy what we will write? On the credit side, what will we write on the buy? There is no concept called as credit purchases in US. Buy inventory. This is the balancing figure. Is it clear, everyone? Inventory would be the balancing figure here. Are you able to understand? That's what they are doing in that Becker, pluses and minuses. Don't memorize that. It's very logical. To cash paid, buy balance brought down, buy inventory. So this is how your accounts payable account is created. Now on inventory, now tell me, I have opened inventory account here. On inventory, what should I do? Opening balance, closing balance now, yes or no? To or buy? I have opened the inventory ledger now. To or buy? Yes, so it shows inventory shows always debit balance, so to balance brought down. Then we have buy balance carried down. Next, we have given one accounts payable entry, right? Accounts payable debit to inventory. In accounts payable, inventory is shown on credit side. So in inventory account, what should we put? To accounts payable, it is nothing but your credit purchases, which are your due to accounts payable. Rest, what will come? 5-star to the people who tell me the balancing figure. Come on. Cost of goods sold, that's all. That is the balancing figure. That is what he did it in the Becker's book. But it's really tough, okay? If you see the presentation in the Becker book, see there what they have done. Cash paid, add ending, subtract AP, add ending, add beginning. So no one will understand anything from this explanation. Are you able to understand? It's always better to open the ledgers and solve this. Are you able to understand what were we trying to achieve by opening those two ledgers? So that I don't want you to memorize like that. Add, subtract, add. See, it is up to you guys. I don't want to force you all because I can just recommend. Recommendation practice is only that you open the TE accounts. I think that is the best way to solve a question rather than this pluses and minuses. The probability of doing wrong is more. Okay, that is the only thing. It's not like Becker haven't explained that or the calculations are not good. But if you open the TE accounts, the things become much easier. That is what I recommend. Okay.